Dr.C.V. Suresh Babu's Virtual Classroom presents Operating Systems Series.
Discussion topics: Process Introduction, Process State Diagram, Process Control Block, Operation of Processes, Process Scheduling, Process Scheduling Queues, Types of Schedulers, Cooperating Process, Inter-Process Communication. Process. A process is basically in execution. The execution of a process must progress in a sequential fashion. When a program is loaded into the memory and it becomes a process, it can be divided into four sections: stack, heap, text, and data.
Difference between program and process. Program has static code and static data. Process has dynamic instance of code and data. One program can invoke multiple process. Process can have multiple processes on the same program. Program is an executable code. Process is a running instance of a program.
Stack. The process stack contains the temporary data such as method parameters, return address, and local variables. Heap. This is dynamically allocated memory to a process during its runtime. Text. This includes the current activity represented by the value of the program counter and the contents of the processor's registers. Data. This section contains the global and static variables. Process state diagram. The lifetime of a process can be divided into several states, each with certain characteristics that describe the process. Start. This is the initial state when a process is first created or started. Steady. The process is waiting to be assigned to a processor. These processes are waiting to have a processor allocated to them by the operating system so that they can run. It will come into this state after start state or while running it, when interrupted by a scheduler to assign CPU to some other process. Running. Once the process has been assigned to the processor by the OS scheduler, the process state is to set to running and the processor executes its instructions. Waiting. Processor moves into waiting state if it needs to wait for a resource, such as waiting for user input or waiting for a file to become available. Terminated or exit. Once the process finishes its execution or it is terminated by the OS, it is moved to the terminated state where it is waiting to be removed from the main memory. Process control block. Each process is represented in the OS by data structure called process control block. The PCB is identified by an integer process ID, PID. A PCB keeps all the information needed to keep track of the process as listed. Process state. The state may be new, ready, running, waiting, or terminated. Program counter indicates the address of the next instruction to be executed for this process. CPU registers. Various CPU registers where process needs to be stored for execution for running state. CPU scheduling information. Process priority and other scheduling information which is required to schedule the process. Memory management information includes the base, limit register values, the page tables or the segment tables. Accounting information includes the amount of CPU usage and real-time use, time limits, account numbers, job or process numbers. IO status information
includes the list of I/O devices allocated to a process. Operation of processes. There are two types of operations of process carried out. Process creation. Process creation is a task of creating new processes. Process termination. Process termination is an operation in which the process is terminated after the execution of its last instruction. Process scheduling. Process scheduling is an OS task that schedules processes for different states like ready, waiting, and running. Need for process scheduling. It allocates a time for each process. It keeps the CPU busy all the time, which allows you to get the minimum response time for programs. Process scheduling queues. When the process enters the system, they are put into queue called scheduling queues. There are three types of operating system queues, and they are job queue, ready queue, device queues. Illustration for process scheduling queue. Every new process is first put into ready queue. It waits in ready queue until it is finally processed for execution. The new process is then put in the ready queue and it waits until it's selected for execution or it is dispatched. One of the process is allocated in the CPU. It is executed. The process should issue an I/O request. Then it should be placed in the I/O queue. The process should create a new subprocess. The process should be waiting for its termination. It should be forcefully removed by the CPU. As a result interrupt, once interrupt is complete, it should be sent back to the ready queue. Types of schedulers. A scheduler is a type of system software that allows you to handle process scheduling. There are mainly three types of process schedulers. Long-term. Long-term scheduler is also known as a job scheduler. The scheduler regulates the program and select process from the queue and loads it into the memory for execution. It also regulates the degree of multiprogramming. Short-term. A short-term scheduler, also known as the CPU scheduler, decides which of the ready in-memory process is to be executed. An I/O interrupt, an operating system call, or another form of signal. Medium-term. Medium-term scheduling is a process of swapping. It removes the process from the memory. It reduces the degree of multiprogramming. The medium-term scheduler is in charge of handling the swapped out process. A running process may become suspended if it makes an I/O request.
Difference between long-term scheduler, short-term scheduler, and medium-term scheduler. A long-term scheduler is a job scheduler. A short-term scheduler, it is a CPU scheduler. Medium-term scheduler is a process swapping scheduler. Long-term scheduler takes process from the job pool. Short-term scheduler takes process from the ready state. Medium-term scheduler takes process from running or dead state. Long-term scheduler has speed lesser than short-term scheduler. Short-term scheduler is the fastest among the two schedulers. The speed of medium-term scheduler is in between long-term and short-term scheduler. Long-term scheduler controls the degree of multiprogramming. Short-term scheduler has less control over the degree of multiprogramming. Medium-term scheduler reduces the degree of multiprogramming.
cooperating process. A process can be of two types: independent process, cooperating process. Independent process, which is not affected by execution of any other process. Cooperating process, it is independent. Cooperating processes are those processes that in effect or are affected by other process running on the system. Cooperating process may share data with each other. Process cooperation is needed for the following reasons: information sharing, computation speed up, convenience, and modularity. Inter-process communication. Inter-process communication is a mechanism which allows all processes to communicate with each other and synchronize their action. The communication between these processes can be seen as a method of cooperation between them. Processes can communicate with each other using these two ways: shared memory and message passing. Shared memory may be simultaneously accessed by multiple programs with an intent to provide communication among them or to avoid copies. Message passing is a model that allows multiprocess to read and write data to the message queue without being connected to each other.
For more detailed information, refer to our book, Operating Systems, Simplified, by Dr.C.V.Suresh Babu. Highlights of our Simplified series. Why should I learn this chapter? Snapshot. Frequently asked question. Summary. Activity. Assignment. Video online. Just before exam. Test yourself. Keywords. Further readings. For more tutorial videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel.